It is an effort of IIP Gurgaon to raise awareness about adolescent health, explain the need of anticipatory guidance, and also bring together various stakeholders, for example, grandparents, parents, school teachers, counselors, mental health professionals, psychologists, adolescent experts, and even adolescents at one platform. Adolescent forms about 22% of the population. Their physical, mental, emotional, and social well-being will determine a nation's health. It takes a village to raise a child. So let's see how we can help our adolescents. Thank you.
So in this COVID pandemic, I want to advise all children, be safe, be healthy. What is health? Health, in simple terms, is a state of physiological and psychosocial well-being. For physiological well-being, simple message is 5-2-1-0. Means 5 or more servings of fruits and veggies, 2 hour or less of screen time, 1 hour of moderate to vigorous physical activity, and 0 sugary drinks. Means reduce your soda or food punches, replace it with plain water, milk, or coconut water. So in the last 5-2-1-0, be a healthy hero.
Mental health of adolescents is very important. It is during this time that their overall physical, emotional, social changes which are happening around them, they start affecting them very strongly. So they get upset very easily, they get hurt very easily, they have become super sensitive, and if these issues are not addressed carefully in the beginning, then it leads to conduct disorders, it leads to smoking or addiction behavior, it leads to sexual aberrations, it leads to other behavioral issues which will affect their later life and mar their personality. So if any changes are being seen in the child, it's always advisable to reach out to a mental health specialist. Social health of adolescence is very important. This is turbulence of adolescence. So much of emotions are changing place every day, and the upheaval of emotions is so strong that it leaves them scattered and leaves them upset and disturbed. And because of hormonal changes are happening, social milieu is changing around them so fast, identity crisis is cropping up, and body image, body shaming around them is becoming such a reality. They are not able to understand that, comprehend so many things which are happening simultaneously. This is a time their self-esteem can be badgered if it is not tackled carefully. So we need to be very, very careful about how we tackle an innocent adolescent at home and outside. So the social behavior of adults is also very important at this stage in dealing with the adolescent.
Friends, today we talk about anticipatory guidance. Anticipatory guidance is when a professional proactively counsels parents, adolescents, and other caregivers about the various physical, mental, and emotional, psychosocial milestones, so that they are aware and are able to smoothly transition through these various events. Anticipatory guidance can be given by healthcare professionals, teachers, parents, grandparents, and even peer educators. Adolescence, as we all know, is a transient phase of human development where there are rapid biopsychosocial changes happening, and this can lead to a lot of confusion, causing morbidity and even mortality. Forearmed, they say, is forewarned. So if they are armed with the knowledge about adolescent issues and know how to handle them, then a lot of physical health issues, mental health issues, risk-taking behavior can be prevented.
I would like to bring forth the perspective of parents in light of adolescent health. These days, because of ready availability of all the information and resources, sometimes it becomes difficult to have cordial relationship between the parents and the children of this age group. Certain issues which I think every parent face are: how do I stop my child from experimenting with drugs, tobacco, and even sex? How do I deal if my child is not straight? And then every child wants their parent to be cool. But what exactly cool means? Is it cool to have beer with your child once he or she turns 18? Since I am a pediatrician, it was slightly easier for me to deal with these issues, but it's not the same for every parent, and they sometimes need proper guidance to tackle with.
Transition of a child to an adolescent is challenging for parents, especially in this era. But what parents need to understand is that they no more have that unquestioned authority over them, and they need to keep a communication channel open by which they get to know their routine. Routine doesn't mean that you start behaving like them or start wearing clothes like them. That is definitely not cool, and they don't like it in fact. To explore is an inherent quality of the adolescents, and they will outgrow their curiosities. You just need to give them a little time. But be observant as to what are their interests, their inclinations, if there are any deviations, the kind of groups they move in, but don't pry on them. Set rules which are realistic, which are adaptable, which are adjustable, and they should be customized for your family. Like wearing shorts is not a big deal for some. Drinking also is common in certain families. And mind you, every opposite gender friend is not a threat for your child. So give them freedom to an extent that they come back to you, and don't stifle them with your restrictions.
As a mother of an adolescent boy, there are many issues or dilemma I face while trying to give a proactive sex education. The first one is how and when to begin. Should I initiate a discussion, or should I wait for him to come to me with a doubt and seize the opportunity to discuss the topic further? The second one is how much information to give. I shouldn't be over-informing him, or I shouldn't be bombarding him with all the knowledge he might not need at this time. The third one is, I don't know how he's going to process the information or how he's going to take the information. He might go and brag about this to his peers who might not be ready for this kind of information.
Adolescent sexuality education is a very important topic, and I am going to enumerate four quick points. Number one, keeping the channels of communication open from the beginning. This will help you have a rapport with the child, and you can discuss anything with the child. Even the sexuality will be easy for you to discuss. Number two, the information you provide to the child should be age appropriate and relevant. You can take a cue from whatever he is being taught in the school. It could be body parts or it could be reproductive process. Number three, look for the teaching movements around you. For example, you can talk about menstruation when the advertisement of sanitary napkins is being shown on a television, or you can discuss about rape when an incident of rape is being reported in the newspaper. Let it be a two-way discussion and a thought-provoking one as well. Number four, there will be certain topics like masturbation and night falls which will be difficult to discuss for parents. Then you can find somebody trustworthy. It could be counselor in the school, it could be teacher, pediatrician, or an adolescent expert, and let your teenager speak to him, because these are normal things and the doubts of a teenager must be allayed. Thank you.
Hello friends. It's very important to teach our teenagers about the reproductive health. It should be age appropriate, like a girl of 6 to 8 years should know about her body parts and safe touch. Before attaining puberty, we should also impart knowledge about menstrual hygiene and menstrual cycle to the teenager so that she knows how to take care of it. And she should also know how a pregnancy occurs when you indulge in sex. Next, we can give all this information by using audiovisual aids and charts, or use of social media like Instagram and Facebook, where all these adolescents are very active and they like to read about blogs, and knowledge can be imparted in a better way there. We should also involve their parents, especially the mother, to make them understand what is safe sex. Before becoming sexually active, the girl child should know that she can be prevented against unwanted pregnancies and sexually transmitted disease by use of contraception. The laws of the local area, like we have the POXO law, also can be taught to these teenagers in the reproductive health education, which is very important part of the this sort of education. Thanks.
As is being proved scientifically and accepted by WHO that the womb journey and early infancy is the most important phase of our life when the foundation for whole life is being laid down. So, the conscious conception and early childhood parenting is being considered vital for the happy and thriving individual of who is to be born. This can only be achieved by nurturing the adolescents who are going to be the future parents by a complete non-judgmental involvement in their life, enabling them to become empowered and growing individuals by parents themselves or involving a mentor if they need it.
Considering the fact that it is still a taboo to communicate sex education directly to children, parents usually avoid it, which becomes harmful for children in the longer run because they themselves seek it from other sources, which might influence them in a negative way. So it is important to empower young people with accurate, age-appropriate and culturally relevant information. School plays an important role in this. It is the duty of the school to give education not only in a formal way but also related with each level of children, which helps to sensitize the teens in the class so that they can embrace their sexuality instead of being misled, misguided by the existing information in the society.
We are trying to talk to the people and know, hey, what are the hurdles in giving sexuality education to the children. The most important, there are 3 to 4 points which are very genuine points. One is the time given to the teachers. They have to have various kind of activities and sometimes they do not have time for that. Second thing is sometimes there is a lack of awareness of these teachers in giving this sexuality education. Third thing, it is this kind of a topic is never discussed in our society as well as in the families. So nobody understands it. Advantage of giving this kind of education. And then sometimes there are a lot of vacation times, then exam times. Sometimes the children are not able to cope up with all the education which we try to give. So CBSE and other bodies, they should try to incorporate into the courses so that they can be made available to the patient and to the parents. So parent education is very important as well as the education of the teachers is very important. Thank you.
A mental health professional has to really work very hard, has to learn to be beyond, has to learn to control her or his own anxieties. My dear school counselor friends, I request you and the principals, I request you to kindly appoint the trained counselors as mental health professionals. Thank you.
I believe children should be given sex education because they need to know about the changes taking place in their body and to avoid being misled by the myths. And moreover, since due to certain factors, the age of attainment of puberty is decreasing, so I believe that it should be given at an earlier age.
In this difficult time of corona pandemic, let's have a word from our counselor how to keep ourselves mentally strong.
The journey of self-love isn't easy, but it will definitely be worth it. So remember, winter always turns to spring. So, my friends, start by being kind to yourself, grateful for what you have, and finding happiness in small things. You have the power to change your life. So, one day at a time.
Adolescents with the chronic illnesses like diabetes and asthma will also face the adolescent issues and often poor compliance to treatment and self-care. We have to take care of these adolescents with the more love and patience along with the medications. Adolescents with the special needs like the autism, cerebral palsy, intellectual disability also require the age and development appropriate anticipated guidance and care. Taking care of these adolescents at home is challenge for the parents, so we have to support the parents also.
Adolescent health education and adolescent health should be our priority, because even in our country, adolescents are the major part of the population. If you look in the numbers, there are around 234 million adolescents are there in India. They take an important part in democracy and economy of a country. They are the future of country. So to support this, even government has started a program which is called RKSK, that is Rashtriya Kishore Swasth Karyakram. Even our Indian Academy of Pediatrics and AHA, Adolescent Health Academy, are also taking part in different branches in different states of the country. Some NGOs programs like Udaan, AKI, also taking an important part to enhance this.
Namaskar, I am Dr. Mahavir Jain, President IMA Gurgaon. IAP Gurgaon को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देता हूँ कि उन्होंने अवेयरनेस ऑफ एडोलसेंट हेल्थ केयर इन मेडिकल प्रोफेशनल्स का अभियान शुरू किया है। एडोलसेंट या कहें टीनेजर ज़िंदगी की एक बहुत महत्वपूर्ण अवस्था है, जब बहुत सारे शारीरिक एवं मानसिक चेंजेस होते हैं। सभी डॉक्टर्स को इन सभी का नॉलेज होना बहुत ज़रूरी है, ताकि हम इन सभी टीनेजर्स की समस्याओं को एक होलिस्टिक एवं कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव अप्रोच रख सकते हैं। आप सभी से मेरा अनुरोध है कि ज़िंदगी के इस स्पेशल लाइफ पीरियड को स्पेशल अटेंशन, अपनी प्रैक्टिस में बड़ा स्पेशल अटेंशन दें, ताकि इन सभी टीनेजर्स का शारीरिक व मानसिक ट्रांजिशन एक अच्छे एडल्ट व रेस्पॉन्सिबल सिटीजन के रूप में हो सके। बहुत सारी ऐसी जो बीमारियां हैं जो इस एज में शुरू होती हैं और आगे भी चलती हैं, स्पेशली लाइफस्टाइल डिजीज़ेस, उन सभी के बारे में भी ट्रांजिशन बड़ा स्मूथ होगा। इसलिए अपनी प्रैक्टिस में हम सभी इसके लिए एक स्पेशल अटेंशन दें। धन्यवाद।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई वांट टू टॉक अबाउट द एडोलेसेंस टुडे। द मेंटल हेल्थ ऑफ एडोलेसेंस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, and in their learning environment, two most important agencies are the families at home and the school teachers. Unfortunately, the teachers keep on telling that the parents do not take the responsibility, while the parents keep telling that the teachers are not taking the responsibility. Who is going to bridge this gap? That is school counselor only. Sex education is another serious issue, which is not being taken care of either by the parents or the teachers. Again, who is going to take care of? That is the school counselor. So the school counselor has to know positive parenting, how to train the teachers, and how to develop the complete potential of a student and train the student of the life skills. Therefore, I request all the counselors to kindly complete your training at least for 1 year under someone's supervision, so that you know how to create the milieu and take care of the students' adolescents' mental health. Thank you so much.
You just heard the viewpoints on adolescence by other people. I would like to discuss solutions. First thing to remember, human parenting is not an inborn skill. And hence, to deal with today's adolescents, parents need to get training on parenting skills. Similarly, teachers need training to deal with today's adolescent, both in school and colleges. IAP and AHA conduct regular programs for training parents and teachers. I would request all of you to take advantage of these programs, so dealing with adolescents will become a joyful experience. Today's adolescents are also facing a lot of stress in the highly competitive world and the social media's pressure. They also need to have training, to have skills to deal with these issues. All parents spend a lot of money on tuitions for developing IQ or intelligence quotient. But more important in life is EQ, emotional quotient, which helps to deal with relationships and be happy in life. We also need to develop adversity quotient or adjustability quotient. This helps children to deal with problems and develop resilience, that is ability to bounce back. With nuclear families, affluent parents, children don't get no for an answer, and hence whenever adversity comes, they collapse. And we have seen the tragic news almost every day of young lives taking their lives. So we have to train children to develop skills which can be done through a WHO program called Life Skill Education. I request all parents and teachers to see that the adolescents get trained in life skill education. Thank you.